It's July 2023 and time for a new version of Home Assistant that will be released on the first Wednesday of this month. And it's a big one this time. Let's go through the beta version to see what will be released in Home Assistant 2023.7 this upcoming Wednesday. Boy, time flies. Here's another new version of Home Assistant. This time it's version 2023.7 and it's packed with a lot of new functionalities. This version is based on the beta version of Home Assistant 2023.7. The final version might slightly differ from what you'll see in this video. The first big addition in this version is an advanced feature that will allow for a lot of new possibilities. When you create automations and scripts, you can use service calls in the action part of the automation or script. In previous versions of Home Assistant, you could only fire a service call like turning on a light or toggling a switch. But now the service call can also respond with data. So, what does this mean? You can now ask Home Assistant for information from a device or service. For example, you can show all the calendar events for the upcoming days, hours or minutes. At the moment, there are two new services that you can use. The service calendar.listEvents returns all the upcoming events in a calendar. You can test it in the developer tools like this. Go to the top services and select the service calendar.listEvents. Select the target calendar. Select the duration, for instance 48 hours, and click call service. A list of events will show now. I will create a tutorial in the near future on how you can utilize this to show agenda items on your smartphone or dashboard when you call this service. The second new service is the conversation.process service. With this service, you can ask to assist a command and get a response back. You can, for instance, ask what lights are on in the house, but there's much more possible. It's currently in an early stage of development. As soon as it's more robust, I will create a tutorial to show you how you can utilize this. Home Assistant is focusing on the UI, and this time a new entity dialog is added for locks. I do not own a smart lock myself, but it shows the state while locking and when it's locked or unlocked. It's now possible to create a button on your dashboard to open the assist action. It's still not a wake word, but if you have a tablet on your wall and you want to quickly use the speech-to-text function of Home Assistant, you can now start assist by simply pressing a button. Turn on backlight.
Turned on light.
Now that Home Assistant is focusing more on speech, more functionalities are released to support that every month. This time it's the sentence trigger. This trigger can be used in automations to trigger an automation based on a specific sentence that you say to assist. For instance, you can now create a sentence that announces a message to all your smart speakers that dinner is ready. For this, go to Settings, Automations and Scenes and create a new automation. Choose the trigger sentence. For the action, add a call service action and choose the text to speech and service and fill in all the fields. Now, when you say dinner is ready to assist, your speaker should announce that dinner is ready. Dinner is ready.
Dinner is ready.
I know you can also create a button for this, and that is currently probably a faster way to do it, but as soon as the wake word functionality will be available in Home Assistant, this will help in making automations respond to your voice. Next to the camera entity, there's an image entity now to provide images. It currently works for Fritzbox tools and the MQTT and template integrations if you want to create your own image entity. If you want to create your own image entity, you can create a template like this. The image needs to point to a URL. You can show the image entity using the picture card, the picture glance card or the tile card on your dashboard. Dashboards do have copy and paste functionality now. You can cut, copy and paste a card from one view in a dashboard to another view in that same or another dashboard. The duplicate option for a card already existed, but that could only be done within the same view. Now you can cut, copy and paste to other views, which I think is really handy. But there's more. You can now see what the order of the cards is. When you put your dashboard in edit mode, you see the order number of the card in the card, and you can change that number so that the card gets positioned in a different position on the dashboard. It's not drag and drop yet, but it comes close. The Create Automation dialog already showed the automation blueprints, but the Create Script dialog did not show the script blueprints. This is added in Home Assistant 2023.7 so that the Create Script dialog shows the script blueprints now too. When you go to your user profile, you can now choose the time zone that you're in. This is useful when you're traveling a lot or if you manage multiple Home Assistant instances that are in different time zones. You can choose your local time zone or the time zone that your server is in. And there is a UI change for the integration dashboard again. It's even cleaner than the last change in Home Assistant 2023.6. The icons are now shown in a different location on the integration card. You can click the header to enter the integration, and the cogwheel, device and service items have been removed. Sometimes a YAML configuration option is removed and causes a breaking change. This can be a frustrating thing, especially if you're not warned a long time before this remove is introduced. So from now on, when a YAML configuration option will be removed, it will be shown as deprecated for 6 months before it is removed. This way you have a lot of time to fix the issue before the YAML configuration option gets removed from Home Assistant. Until now, automations and scripts were not shown in the automation or script list when they contained an error. This has changed so that you do see the automations and scripts that contain an error now. This way it's much easier to fix the automations and scripts that contain issues. When you open such an automation or script, you will get a hint about what's wrong with it. If you use Bluetooth, you can use a Bluetooth dongle or a Bluetooth proxy using ESP Home. The ESP Home code for Bluetooth proxies has been updated in Home Assistant 2023.7 so that they are now even faster than using a standard Bluetooth dongle in your Home Assistant server. As in all new versions of Home Assistant, this release contains some new meta updates that improve speed and stability. Next to all the new functionalities that I already mentioned, there are more changes in the Noteworthy changes list. You can find this list on the release notes page, which are linked in the description below. Next to these Noteworthy changes, these new integrations are available too, and these integrations can now be set up using the UI. As always, this video is created based on the beta release of Home Assistant 2023.7, so the functionalities in the final release might slightly differ from what's in the beta. The final release of Home Assistant 2023.7 will be released on the first Wednesday of July. Make sure you read the breaking changes to prevent you run into any trouble after you've updated to this version. If you like what I do, please consider sponsoring me with a small amount of money so I can keep this channel alive. Links to Patreon, Ko-fi and joining my channel are in the description below. I'd like to thank all the awesome people on this list that became my sponsors. You play a vital role to keep this channel alive. Thanks. And please do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye. Script. Oh man. Okay. Shows the script blueprints again. Oh man. Difficult.